Hey YouTube, time for a shrimp update. End of March 2017. Stay tuned. Hey YouTube, it's Brian again giving you a shrimp update today. Let's just get right into it. We'll start over here like we always do. These are the lower grade crystal reds, A through S grade. I've added some additional blood to this tank and from a couple different sources just to kind of keep it strong. And they're still continuing to breed like crazy. As you can see, there's a lot of juvies in there. There's buried females and there's babies and stuff like that. So everything is going real well still in this tank. You can see them all over the walls and stuff too, but right now I'm feeding them, so they're gonna all be up front. Next door is kind of a mixed tank. Got some pintos in here right now, and the few Thai bees that survived from this project, if you remember, in this tank, and then one crystal red that came from the same batch of babies that the Thai bees came from. It was kind of a mixed batch because it was a royal blue tiger and a PRL. So then I've also got an Aura blue tiger, or two Aura blue tiger males in there, and a tangerine tiger male. I'm gonna separate a lot of this stuff out, but for now it's just kind of a mixed tank. But got some pintos and they're doing pretty well. I'm pretty happy about that. Some of the black pintos, mixed types, as you can see in there. A few of them towards the back of the tank as well. I don't know if you can really see, but I'll sit down here so I can get more at the substrate level. Next door here are some more crystal reds, a little bit higher grade, SS through SSS, I guess. These guys have been doing real good lately. I've seen some buried females. I've seen a few little babies here and there, not a ton. But I've also got some, I guess they were sold to me as goldens. Like there's one right alongside of the petri dish there, and there's a couple inside, where they're pretty much all kind of a whitish golden color. So I'm pretty happy with how this tank's been coming along. The pinto, this one, and the next tank, I've switched substrate out in the last few months, and that's really seemed to help things out all around, so that's good. You just gotta keep track of how old the substrate is and what type of pH you're getting, if it's still working for you or not. So what I've done on all my tanks as I've been switching it out is I just kind of put a little, like this has got ADA Amazonia. This is when I put it in the tank, and I used on this one that ProBDO, whatever you want to call it, startup or whatever it's called, those vials to get things going. This one I didn't. I just used straight up Amazonia and cycled it for a month. And this one I use the SL Aqua Soil. And that brings me to this tank next door, are the PRLs. These are some of the original ones I had. And I've added a couple other bloodlines to them over the past, month or so. And things are going real well in here, as you can see. Very active. I'm very happy about that. Ooh, I think I just saw a buried female scoot by on the bottom here. Sorry, that's out of focus. On this tank, I've got this little carrier where I've got all my foods and crap like that, so it's a little hard to get in this close. But anyway, so yeah, things are going real well here. Couldn't be happier. Need to do some trimming of the mini Pellia back here. In all these tanks now too, or most of my tanks, all these over here, as you can see, I've got the bigger Choya wood, the, I guess they call it teddy bear, And then I've got some boost in each of these tanks as well. So I'm looking forward to growing out some of that boost. Got some real nice boost from Eric Lucas, bypetshrimp.com, if you're looking for that. Also, I just want to say too, the SL Aqua Soil that I've got in this tank and a couple of my other tanks, that's real good soil that you can get through Eric Martin's at discobee.com. So if you're looking for that. Next door here is a tank that's fairly new in its infancy. This used to be a Taiwan bee tank, if you remember. I've now got Prodibio, whatever, aqua shrimp powder. I've got this in a few tanks now. And so this tank's fairly new, and I've got some small but super crystal reds in here. There's another one over here. Just an order of, I think it was 10 of them, picked up a week or two ago. So they're doing good. A lot of film and stuff on the glass here so it doesn't look as nice. Down below now are where my Taiwan bees are. Well, I mean, I've always had one group down here, but I combined the groups because I only had a handful left on the group that was in the upper tank. So things are going well. This also has the Prodibio aqua shrimp powder in it. Looking to really grow this colony. Hoping for good things there. Quite a mix, pandas, wine reds, blue bolts, got some BKKs in there. What else? Some red bolts, and also some that are more just pure white that came from the red bolts that didn't really redden up, if you will. A little pinkish, some are white. Thinking about separating those and trying to breed a bunch of a tank full of just more kind of white Caridinas or bees, whatever you want to say. So that's that tank. I'll take you over here to the other rack. Start up above. These reds up here are probably going to get combined. Ooh, a berry female back there. Are probably going to get combined with my other reds a couple tanks below this. Just to have more room. I don't need two tanks full of reds right now. These come from a good bloodline. Up above, over on this side, we've got the Blue Dreams. Doing decent. Haven't seen a lot of breeding lately. There was a buried female in here the other day. Trying to see if I can find her in this group. Yeah, they're doing okay. I'm not seeing die off at all. Just not seeing breeding as quickly as I would like to. But, you know, it is what it is. On the fence as to whether or not I want to keep these. As you'll kind of guess as I continue to go through here, I'm kind of getting away from Neos for the most part and sticking more with Caridina. Alright, down below here is a red pinto tank. I got these in about the same time as those super crystal reds. Both of them I got from Scott Barr. They are obviously small juvies, but doing well so far. I guess these would be what you would call a tiger stripe. I can't remember. I'm new to pintos and I'm learning, but I'm really liking them. This tank was recently set up too. I did the SL Aqua Soil. I went through the whole 30-day setup cycle, whatever you want to call it. Royal Blue Tigers. Wish I had better news, but things just aren't progressing well. Haven't seen any breeding, any babies. Couple die-offs, not a lot, but two or three since the last update. So I'm hoping something changes there. Everything seems to be good parameter-wise. It's just, for whatever reason, they just kind of stopped breeding like crazy like they used to. And that'll happen, obviously, with shrimp or fish or anything from time to time. So we'll just kind of see what happens going forward. Down below here is another red Neo tank. Most of these that, as they get older, turn into what you could call probably painted fire reds, maybe some Sakura. But there's a ton in here, as you can see, and they've been doing really well. This tank's really fun to watch. So this will be one Neo tank that I keep, at least for now. Just because I've always liked especially the really well-colored red cherries, fire reds, whatever you want to say. And they're easy to keep, let's be honest, for the most part. So it's kind of an odd colored one. But that's that. Down below here on the bottom, we've got the crystal black, kind of a mixed grade tank here. Sorry, I had to move a bucket. Couple different bloodlines. The ones that I had were still doing good. I added some additional SSS grades that came from the ones that I used to breed. It's been over a year now when I had a huge explosion of them over on the other side of the room, and then that tank crashed. But I had sold some to a local guy, and he bred them successfully for a while, and then he was getting out of shrimp for a while, I think, or something, and so he sold me some of what he had from that same line, and then I got some from a couple other people, and that's kind of what's going on in this tank. Things are going decent there. I saw some babies the other day when I changed the substrate out. I just put the SL Aqua in here after a 30-day cycle. There was some breeding going on. I probably ended up losing some of the babies because sometimes they just hide down in the substrate, and I had the biggest size of the, I think it was Contra Soil, in the tank before. There was a lot of space for them to get down there, but unfortunately, sometimes that's what happens. But that's a good sign at any rate that they're breeding. This tank here is the Green Jade tank. And I've been selling off a lot of these lately. I've got about 20 left, and they're actually up in this breeder box way up here because I'm about to tear the tank down and put in some active substrate. But I got about 20 of them up here. Let's see if you can see without the light. There's not a lot of good light on here. But if anyone's interested in buying these, let me know. I'd like to move them on. The breeder box is usually on. I just turned it off because they're so loud. And then final tank down here is what's left of the red Rillies. Been selling off those lately too. And I've got probably, I haven't counted, but I would say 20 to 30 of these left. So if anyone's interested in some red Rillies, hit me up. Any of the shrimp I sell, or fish for that matter, the best way to get a hold of me is my email address, and I always put it down in the description below the video. So get in touch with me there. I'm not going to show you anything upstairs today because I've been doing some changes up there. Basically, I've got two tanks that I've recently switched the substrate out, and they're kind of cycling. One, the cycle's finished and I've got some new shrimp in them, but they're at the stages where they're all hiding, and they haven't come out, and they're not wanting to eat yet, which happens a lot of times when you have newer shrimp. So we'll just keep it downstairs today for this update. But yeah, that's really about it for now. Couldn't be happier over on this side of the room right now. Well, most of the fish tanks in general, things have been going pretty good, but the crystals over here just really have been doing nicely for me lately. And that, you know, the for whatever reason, the crystal red style shrimp, whether it be pure red lines or down to the low grade, have just always kind of been my favorite. And just always really like the way they look and everything. So, but I'll wrap it up here for the week or for the month, whatever you want to call it. And one thing too, that's pretty cool is I recently hit 10,000 subscribers on YouTube. So that's pretty cool. That's something I just can't believe that all you people watch my videos, and I'm grateful for it, and it's fun to interact that way. So thanks to everybody that subscribes to me. Thanks to everybody that watches my videos. We're just going to keep going with this, kind of the way we do it. Watch this channel grow, hopefully. If not, no big deal either. It's just kind of fun to do. Thanks to everybody that comments and interacts with me through the YouTube channel. I'm really grateful for it. So until next time, until next video, take care, and we'll see you later.